The Sony RX100 Mark IV is the latest in their 1-inch size sensor pocket shooters. Here's my thoughts on using it to shoot video. Hi, I'm Grant and I've owned the Sony RX100 Mark IV for a couple of months now and I've been using it just about solely to shoot video. I'm not going to go into all the tech specs of this camera because there's plenty of places on the web you can find that. My focus is just about always on how good they are or using them in the real world to shoot video. Firstly, here's a few of the most important video specs of the camera. It has a 1-inch sized sensor. It has a 24 to 70 millimeter zoom lens. It can shoot and record 4K video internally, albeit only for 5 minutes at a time. It can shoot and record video in Sony's S-Log2 format. However, its main party trick, I believe, is its ability to record high frame rates or shoot in super slow-mo. This camera can actually record up to 1,000 frames per second in slow-mo video. Sony is packing a lot of video shooting functionality into its cameras these days, and the menu has a myriad of picture setting or picture profile settings that you can adjust or use. Here's some more sample video footage because it's school holidays here in New Zealand and I am looking after our three kids this afternoon. I thought I would put this camera through its paces. We like to finish every good family shoot with an ice cream. After using the camera for a couple of months now, here's my thoughts on the pros and cons of using this camera to shoot video. First up, the pros. The video quality out of these cameras, in fact out of a lot of these tiny pocket shooters now, is fantastic. The ability to record super slow-mo on these pocket shooters now is amazing. You used to have to pay a lot of money only a very few short years ago for the ability to shoot 120 or 240 or even 1,000 frames a second. The slow-mo is amazing, but the high frame rate recordings of basically the first setting of either 240 or 250 frames a second, depending on whether you are in a PAL or an NTSC country, is the best one in my opinion. As soon as you go higher than that, the picture starts to fall to bits and it's actually not full HD anyway. However, the ability to record 120 frames a second without any time restrictions is probably the best one and the one that I use the most on this camera. The manual controls are fantastic on this camera for manual focusing and manual exposure setting. You can get a shallow depth of field picture out of this camera, maximizing its 1-inch sensor. Built-in ND is another fantastic feature. And I actually also quite like the customizable function menu. This way you can set up all the common features you use or want to change in a quick access menu. The cons, or the things that are not so great about this camera for shooting video. First up, the battery life is not great on this camera. I couldn't give you exact figures, but I've basically got three batteries and I'll just about always use two batteries even if I'm out for half a day mucking around with the camera. This camera is very susceptible to wind noise, and you can see here I've made a couple of modifications by adding some felt over the two microphone holes here. I'm not sure why, but Sony hasn't got around to adding touchscreen LCD monitors to these cameras, which is a function I really like and use on my Canon G7X, for example. I know I said that the customizable menus is a pro or a con of this camera, but it's also, the menu system is also quite complicated and take a bit of getting your head around. And this is another little niggle I have with the camera, is that if you're using this camera for vlogging, which a lot of people do, the record button is quite hidden up the back here and it's quite hard to get to. So competition for this camera, I'm not gonna go too far into it in this video, but its main competition is probably the Canon G7X, which I also own, and I will make a video on directly comparing these two cameras very soon. So in conclusion, it is an amazing little video camera. The ability to now to shoot 4K internal, slow-mo, built-in ND filter, and even Sony's S-Log2, all in a pocket-sized shooter, is amazing. My next video, I will go through how I set up this camera, because it's not as straightforward as you think to maximize shooting video. So stay tuned, subscribe, and as always, thanks for watching.